from a local farmer. So we're trying to cut it up because we got a real big discount to cut it up yourself. So it's pretty exciting stuff over here. This is a cow we bought with four other people, and we're
three other people,
and we're cutting it up. Look at that. That's like a shoulder blade or something like that.
Yeah.
And this is, what parts is this?
Shoulder.
But maybe a tenderloin in there?
You got a piece of tenderloin, yeah.
So we're going to try
right
to...
Right here.
That's a filet mignon. This is a filet mignon. What kind is this?
I have no idea.
So tell me what you're doing now.
Just taking the connective tissues out of the meat itself. It's easier to cook and easier to store.
It'll be more tender that way?
Yes.
So you just have to cut it with a... What kind of knife is that?
This is just the bone-in knife. It's easier to use, and I didn't use it for a while, so it's good.
What's this one?
I thought you have no idea.
It's steak. Looks like a sirloin kind of to me. Yum. What's this, a ribeye?
This is ribs.
Oh, beef ribs?
Beef ribs. See? Ribs.
Oh, wow. That looks great. What's this part?
This is the neck plus the shoulder. So it is going to be a work to get down to it.
Do you know any? What have you got there?
I got some liver, fat, kidney. I got a heart in a bag.
Wow.
Offals.
Offals, the most nutrient-dense food on earth. Yum. When it's fresh like this, it is so good. That looks like a T-bone, doesn't it?
Yes.
You took off the fillet.
Yeah, I'd rather eat the filet instead of the T-bone.
Oh, wow. That's a half of a T-bone.
So that's in New York.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is that what half of a T-bone is?
Yeah,
I didn't
New
know
York
that.
And filet.
I didn't know that. A Florentine style, huh?
Not big enough, though.
Hold it up. This is some of the ground beef I made in the food processor. I just cut it up with this. I had to do really small batches. So I think I did pretty good. I got a lot of fat in there. It has a lot of big chunks of fat, but I've mushed them all up really. Fresh from the farm. How do you know?
Taking too much fat out of the animal. Fat is good, but not just fat. You need the meat.
Yep.
See how the fat's kind of yellow? That means it's grass-fed. What are you going to do with that piece?
just make it as ground beef, I guess. Small, thin slices, so you can have.
So that's like a hind quarter, or a leg.
This is a leg.
Guys, so this is the freezer that we bought for the cow, because we wanted to have a freezer for a while. So we were excited to get this freezer so we could store all, because our freezer upstairs is pretty small. So we got this one for downstairs in our garage, and it's pretty big and it has all this stuff in it. So I'm excited because now we can store lots of stuff and have lots of bones and all different cuts for us to eat over. And we put the date, see the date, so you know how old it is and everything. So we can eat that over the next year or so, and it's a great way to save money. So I hope this video has been really helpful. This is a cow that we got from a local farmer that my husband found, and then he brought it home and we cut it up because we got a discount. If you want to find a local farmer in your area, just go to eatwild.com and you can put in your zip code and you can find a local farmer that you can contact to get a discount on a full cow, or you can split it with another family to save money. And that is a great way to freeze it, and then you have it all year, and you can get things for like $5 or $4 a pound even for a grass-fed cow. And it's a really amazing value, and it saves time and money, and it's very sustainable. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please come back and watch next time. Please like and subscribe, share with a friend. I really appreciate you watching. See you next time. Bye bye.